Before we head into the intro, I just wanted to say hi, because I haven't talked to you all in a while. I'm back after taking a brief hiatus, brief sabbatical, if you want to call it. No, I had a lot of stuff going on, work, personal stuff, health stuff. There's a lot going on over here, but happy to be back, happy to present the following. Here it is. Welcome to Film Study, an All-American Universe podcast with Lexi. I'm Lexi. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, rate the podcast 5 stars, all the stuff that I say all the time. Today, we'll be talking about Spelivia's, I'd say like an abbreviated Spelivia journey on their breakup and them getting back together in season 5, as well as some questions from listeners like you. And so I have Monda on the pod, and I also have Summer, who, welcome back. We haven't done much, but I'm really excited to have you on. Spelivia.aa on IG. We're gonna have a fun time. I always like to mix up the voices that we hear on the podcast.
This is the first time getting somebody else experienced me, so hey.
Exactly. We're bringing in a new voice to the Spelivia conversations. Yeah. First-hand experience.
Someone just know that I'm cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, and it's okay.
I love that. Hey, I love that. I love that.
I'm excited to talk about it with both of you, because I'm sure that we all have similar and different opinions on like everything Spelivia. So I think it's going to be a fun conversation, interesting conversation. And let's get into it. So the first question, I think I'm like infamous for this, like asking where Spelivia is at in the sort of thumbs up, thumbs in the middle, thumbs down to their communication. But I'm not going to ask that today. Instead, I'm going to ask, do we think, and this is actually a listener question, do we think that Spelivia has made progress in their communication? Progress since the end of season 4. Do we think, and we can sort of give it like beginning, middle, end of the season. Do you think progress was made? Where is it? So what would you say, like journey season 5, where their communication is at?
I know that's like
roundabout question, so I apologize, but I also have my answer. So if y'all want to think about it.
Oh, I know my answer, but I was just trying to be kind to the new
guest.
Wait,
we got beginning, middle, and end, right?
Right.
Or so beginning of the season, middle of the season, end of the season, where's their communication?
Honestly, from the beginning, it was pretty much on a decline. I have to say that. And then I don't know if it changed much. I haven't really seen any, like, well, I don't know. I think they're just being honest with themselves more towards the end. That's about it.
Yeah, so you're like, beginning and middle were sort of the same, and then the end is like when it really got better. And I'm just going to ask you this question. Is it like ending like the last episode, or is it like ending as in like the last scene when they were together, like when it started together?
Literally the very last episode, the very last scene.
I am liking Summer.
It took a while for us to get there, but we finally got a little something. It's a start.
See, and you think I'm bad. I like that, Summer. Tell that truth, T.
Go ahead.
You know, I know that, you know me, that communication at the beginning was complete trash, to the point that they were on opposite ends of the spectrum of where their relationship was going, how much of trash it was. In the middle, they didn't really have any for me, because they were doing their separate things. They would come together, but they were doing their separate things. And I'm with Summer. It didn't pick up until that very end. Even though they were there for each other during Billy's like death and grief and everything, they still didn't talk about them, and they didn't communicate what was truly going on in their heart, particularly Spencer, heart and mind, because, you know, we're not going to talk about that shit. But very much so, the end, the very end, by the way.
kiss.
Right, the scene where they got with someone. Yeah. I'm going to say, and again, I laugh every time we get this question because I think that when we first brought up this question, whenever we did it, season four into season three, whatever it was.
Yeah. People was hating.
I think that some people were shocked. I myself was one of those people that were shocked, that was just like, ah, their communication isn't as amazing as I had once thought it was, just looking closely at it. Yeah. I actually think that at the end of episode 1501 and through, I'm gonna say, like, up until we got to the wedding episode, I think their communication was the best it's ever been.
Are you serious?
Maybe up until now. Hold on. Can I finish my point?
You're going to have to explain that one. Hold on.
I will explain it. I think their communication after they broke up, post-breakup, up until the wedding episode, was some of the most honest conversations. They didn't have many conversations, but some of the most honest conversations they've ever had in terms of, this is really difficult. I have not moved on. It was really up until, you know, Liv kind of said, like, that was closure. But at the time, she really did think it was closure. And so I think it's, like, up until that moment at the wedding where they didn't say exactly what they wanted, they were actually being very, very honest about their feelings to each other post-breakup and their feelings, like, about each other to other people. And wait, then I feel like when we got...
Go ahead. I can't cut you off. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
No. Go ahead, because I know where I'm going.
So this boy was starting a whole new relationship and wasn't telling Liv Jack.
That part.
Thank you, Summer.
Did I not say up until the wedding, though?
No, that was before the wedding. Remember, the op spilled the beans. And they were not talking.
The wedding episode. But my point is that they were saying things to each other, minus the whole Alicia thing, which is why I'm getting to, once it got to the wedding, their communication was back in the crapper again up until the end, the very last scene of the episode. And there were, like, ebbs and flows throughout that. Like, they had moments where they were honest with each other. But I'm going to say it was, like, their breakup conversation where I think that Spencer did the right thing. Even though I don't think
he did the right thing, break up with him. Right.
And I think he made some assumptions on Liv's part. But I think that they were honest with their feelings, like what they felt up until the wedding episode. Let me correct myself, Monda. The wedding episode, and then from wedding episode on to 5/20, it was in the crapper and didn't get until the last season.
Can I just say that breakup conversation, while they needed to break up, you know me, I was ready for them to break up because I like the angst. He wasn't truly truthful, though.
I don't think so either. It's something that weren't said.
Let's get into that right now. That's fine. But we'll get into that right now because, as I said, I think that this is what he said when they broke up. He said, "Liv, I love you. Loving you is something that I have to do for the rest of my life. And I, you know, want to put you first. I got to put that first." And he was talking about just how he goes out of his ways to see her, and that he saw her happy and thriving, and that he felt like her light dims a little bit when he's around at that time. And then she says, like, he's wrong. She tells him he's wrong, and then says that, like, she loves him. And then they just have a conversation about her dreams. And he says, "You know what? You would never ask me to walk away from my football dreams. I'm not going to ask you to walk away from your journalism dreams." And this article, essentially the article, is too much for them to right now handle at the time. And so you all think that he wasn't being honest in his feelings that he really felt at the time? Explain why.
I think that he was about 85% truthful.
So there you go.
But, no,
No, because I'm going to challenge you on this, Monda. I'm going to challenge you on this, Monda.
He left out some key pieces. He left out some key pieces,
but this was his feelings at the time. And that's what I'm talking about.
But it was more than... But here's the deal. That was... No.
He didn't ask her. He made some assumptions, as he always makes assumptions.
Wait, that's not it. I also think that there's some pieces of his feelings that he did not share. Because Spencer did not know how to fit into her world. He saw it from the outside. They both wasn't speaking for 6 weeks, which is on both their parts. I always say the lack of communication is on both their parts. And everything. But there, he was 100% truthful. That boy did not know how to fit into her world at all.
Oh, those are facts.
Those are facts. And that was a. And
but
that
I'm
was,
not saying he.
He was looking from the outside, not knowing how to fit in, and not even wanting to like work with trying to figure out. Because one of the things I think he was feeling was that she was moving on without him, and so he cut that cord first.
Yes, that's what it was.
He cut that cord first. Because that abandonment issue came front, still in the head, like she's moving away. And she's continuously moving away.
I still don't understand how you think that I was incorrect, though, in my assessment, that it was their best it's ever been this season.
It wasn't the best they ever did. Because he hadn't told her 100% everything.
But I'm saying this season.
Okay, compared it to the other seasons,
but what I'm saying is this
it to the
season.
Other seasons. We just compared it to this season alone.
But no. Mess. That's what I'm talking about. What I'm saying is this season, if you count the times where he was, even him being 85% truthful was, I want to say it was probably like 65% more truthful than he was So I just wanted to add some clarity to my statement earlier. So people are like, what are you talking about? There is a reason for why I said that early on, like right after their breakup, I do think that they were feeling their feelings and being very, very honest about where they both were at, that it sucked, that they didn't really want to be in that spot. And then it was after... you know, around the time of the wedding where it just really, they stopped that, I think, honesty, that 85% honesty that they had.
I'm going to slightly accept that. Slightly.
Sorry, but go ahead, Summer.
Go ahead, Summer.
But, I mean, my answer was basically what Monda just said. Like, I feel like he felt like he didn't know how to like be a part of what she had going on in her growth journey. And he just like was like, okay, so she must be happier without me. And I don't know what that is, but that's just how I felt about it. I feel like they should have had a conversation about it before they just went and broke things off though.
Yep. Yeah,
he should have just said, baby, I don't know where I fit here. Because it was interesting, like, if you go back to the previous season, when he couldn't manage, like, his schedule or whatever, and at the end, and they had the first argument, like, that big argument, he said, I will figure it out. And she said, no, we will figure it out. But when it came to her, like, him trying to figure out how to fit into her world, he was like, he couldn't figure it out, so he just cut it. Instead of figuring it out, he just cut it.
And that's the thing, is I think this season for them was mostly a story about them making a lot of assumptions and assuming that they knew what the other person was thinking. Even though they were being completely, like, I think... not completely. At some points, they were being completely truthful and honest about what they thought. It's that those thoughts were making assumptions. Like, two things can be true at once. What's true for you might not be true for me, which is what we saw in their breakup. Is like, you know, and you know, as we get into it, you know, moving along the first half of season 5, they're both dealing with the breakup in different ways. Obviously, we mentioned that, you know, Liv talks about how, you know, being being apart, not being around him, or being around him rather, sorry, messes her up a lot because they've broken up.
I like that honesty.
Mm-hmm. I love that. That's what I'm saying. It was
I love that, and I love when she didn't apologize, and he thought she's like, I'm not apologizing.
Maybe I should just clarify. 503 is the most honest conversation they had. Maybe that's just what I'm saying. Is it was all 503.
Yeah, now that I'm remembering, yeah.
503 was the most honest they had. Honest.
Yep. So that, let me amend that. 503 is the most honest they've been. Not necessarily, but it's like still before the wedding.
And I think it was more honesty on Liv's part than his, because she was like, you're not mansplaining anything to me.
Yeah.
I think he was honest as well, because he said he had that whole response to her that he said, like, I'm sorry that I haven't found a way to not piss you off. Right. And so I don't think it was just on her end, because they were trying to navigate being in this broken up stage. And he was just like, I apologize for overstepping. They were both being honest about, we're not sure how to navigate being friends in this broken up state and being still in each other's lives in this broken up state. And then we get to the wedding where, you know, Spencer's moving on ish with Alicia, and Coop obviously calls it out. I don't even want to spend time on that girl.
Can I just say that I've had a lot to do with Spencer's thinking at the beginning and towards this breakup, because she was just talking in his ear constantly.
I agree. I think a lot of these things, because you think about the very the second episode, right? When she's like, Liv
even the first one, she was like, y'all gotta hang up the tent.
Why would you say something?
Coop is the biggest op there is. Coop is the biggest op there is.
My goodness.
That's her name, is the op.
Biggest op there is. But throughout the wedding, that's when things, it's like some time has passed since they've broken up. And they sleep together. And even though Liv helps Spencer tremendously with the wedding, they have this moment at the wedding where they're standing together and he's talking about, oh, it feels like you're doing girlfriend type of things. And essentially she says, this is closure. Like, we don't need to talk about us sleeping together because it was closure. That's what it was. And Spencer tears up a little bit, but he agrees with her. So he like literally lied, because we as the audience know, right? This man does not want to call this closure. He doesn't want to call this over. But
he's also trying to have his cake and eat it too. So I understand why she said this was closure.
I'm kind of with you on that. I'm like, don't be texting other chicks in my face.
And it was just like the girlfriend line, like it just felt like a slap in the face, because it's like, it really you broke up with me.
You texted another chick.
Like, we know, I'm a wife. Like, this is what I do, but you broke up with me. Like, you can't just, like, it doesn't
pick
work
up
like
when you
that.
Want to.
Yeah,
pick it up when you want to. It was also that Coop, obviously everything's Coop, right? But Coop was the one that said that Spencer slept with the other girl anyway.
Yep. She said they hooked up, but we don't know if they slept with each other. I think it was just a hook up.
Yeah,
like,
we still don't know the context of.
Yeah, we still don't know
what
the context
that was, because
it's giving sleep together.
You think it is giving sleep together?
I do think it was
good. I think it's that they hung out.
I don't even know.
And they hadn't slept together until after he slept with Liv. And she said, I slept with Ricardo. They nasty tails. And that's when I think they slept together.
And
the reason why I say this is because those writers, when they are intentional, when someone sleeps together, they're going to tell you they slept together or show you that they slept together.
I don't always think that's the case, but
I think it is.
Yeah,
and
I just think that it's unclear. We have different interpretations of that, but
yeah, I don't know. Because hookup can mean a lot of different things.
Yes, either way, some stuff happened. It's basically,
but either way,
exactly. And so the next couple episodes, it's just them being apart, right? It's they're not together for Valentine's Day. The flowers aren't for
when
you.
When he told her that them flowers wasn't for her, if I was her, I would have took them flowers and slapped them with them.
It wasn't necessary.
I would have slapped them in my parents' house. I would have slapped you with those flowers, necessary. The ones you brought.
It was not necessary. And this is, so I guess only because, Summer, you saying it wasn't necessary sparked a question in me, but what's really going through Spencer's mind? Because I think a question that I wondered as I was watching this season was, you know, Spencer clearly does not move on. And maybe I should have kept this question, but I'm going to ask it here anyway. But Spencer clearly hasn't moved on. In some ways, he doesn't want to move on. And in other ways, he's doing everything he possibly can to move on. So what is Spencer really thinking during this time where it seems like he sort of has one foot in, one foot out? Where I think that Liv was a little bit more consistent in, or a lot of bit more consistent in, just that she, you know, even if she wasn't with Spencer, it was very clear that she was still like mourning that, and very clear that that's still something that she had desired.
Yes, yes.
So what's your question?
Yeah,
what's going through Spencer's mind?
Oh, well, during that time. Ooh.
Yeah.
You want to take it, Summer?
I think he just... I never know with Spencer. Like, he just... His actions and his words just be... They flip-flop a lot. And he does things that I just feel like, why are you doing this if you know you feel this way? Like, that's why it was just weird to me how that girl was still around for that long. It's because he just was coasting, you know? Like, he didn't really make a move. He was just very stagnant in that space. So I don't know what he was trying to do.
I don't think Spencer knew what he was trying to do.
That's just the title of this podcast, is that I just don't think that Spencer knew what Spencer wanted
like,
to do.
Like, it's just, I don't know, certain things he says, like, why are you saying that?
The flowers aren't for you.
For you. And I think, my thing is, there's two things that make me feel bad for Spencer, and one is that he broke his own heart when he like broke up with her and then assumed my sister was going to be back together after they slept together. But I think because he was so in love with Liv, and this is a love he's never experienced before, and when he's broken up with people in the past, let it be Kia, let it be Lele and things of that nature, he will like find some way, even for like a hot second, he'll be in mourning, and he could then start like picking things up with other people, right? But this time he couldn't do it. He was just like, okay, I'm going to try it, but I'm going to go to a party. Let me bring this girl back to the room. I can't even do anything with this girl. Let me kick her out. Let me call Liv and listen to Liv's voicemail. Wow, everybody else is encouraging.
What would you say to her if she picked up?
Honestly, I wish he would have picked up.
Because she saw that smash too. I wish he would have picked up.
What would he have said? Like
I just had a girl in my room and I couldn't do it. I couldn't get it up. Like, no, what are you doing?
I think he just would have been like, we should talk or something along the lines of that.
Live out of a newfound hoodoo.
I don't think he would have mentioned anything about that girl. He's not that dumb.
He wouldn't have done it. But Liv had already saw everything. He doesn't know that at the time. Liv had already saw the smash tour. So she would have been like, that's true.
No, and so I was going to say, it's just very clear. There is no sort of plans or thought out process. I think it was very coasting was a really great word to describe Spencer, I think, just throughout the season, especially at the beginning of the season. And then we get to 506 and 507 when really the main issue of their breakup, I think, comes to a head. And a lot of people were just like, I don't understand why they broke up. I think that Summer, I don't know where you were on this sort of this debate, this argument, but I think that Monda and I had a pretty good idea of why they broke up, and a lot of it was
What you talking about?
No, don't be telling the people that. Look,
I'm gonna tell y'all this. I predicted all this whole storyline. I even got your
We predicted it. We didn't plan it, but we predicted it. We had some thoughts, and they ended up being very, very accurate thoughts.
Right.
But a lot of it had to do with this. I think that it's very funny that this character said it, but Grace in season 4, at the end of season 4, said this really, really great line, and I think that sums up Spencer and Olivia's breakup really well. Mm-hmm. Is Spencer, you've known your dream since you were a kid, and Olivia is just figuring out hers. And so, to Monda's earlier point about how does Spencer fit in Liv's world when she's figuring out her dreams, particularly her dreams when it comes to being a journalist, and really, really getting into her career with journalism. And so, like I said, this idea comes to a head when the article is about to be released. It's been worked on the first part of the season. The article is about to be released, and Garrett steps down right before Liv is about to drop the article. Mm-hmm. And Spencer and Liv have a conversation, and Spencer assumes that Liv won't be dropping the article because Garrett had stepped down. Then Liv has this conversation where she's just like, I'm still going to drop it because this is bigger than all of us. And he asked this question, do you, Olivia Baker, have to be the one that drops this thing?
Which, when he said that, that was the first time I was ready to go into a TV screen and strangle somebody.
You're lying, because you have had that thought several times before with this exact couple.
You're that exact couple, but like, no, literally, I was ready to step onto that.
You're like, no, but it was for real this time.
It was for real this time. Because I was like, she did all this work. Yep. All this work. You got relationship. Part of your relationship was because of her passion around this work. Part of it. It was a breakup on this. Mm-hmm. She has isolated herself away from people. Her brother, everyone. To finish this article. And then you have the audacity to be like, why you? He would never say, if he was on the football field, that he, like, it comes down, he go ahead and let somebody else make the touchdown. When he's at the 1 yard line, is he going to pass it off to someone else so they can go across the line, but he wanted her to do it? Like, here, you make, let somebody else make that touchdown for you. He would never want somebody to do that to him and request that of him. If Billy or a coach asked him that, but you go ask her, you about to make this touchdown, but how about you hand it to somebody else and let them walk across the line? I was like, boy, I will knock you. No, both him and Jordan assumed that she wasn't going to write it or anymore. I was like, no, she still has to say it because he was still being treacherous through the collegiate athletics. So he had to be exposed.
I think that whole scene just frustrated me because it's just like, we were just going through this whole process of him trying to help her with this article. Like, you'd assume he'd know the extent of the reason why she needed to do this. And it just was like, why would she not want her name on that? Like, she did it. I don't know.
Yeah, for me, I think when I first was watching this in real time, I immediately went back to when he first attempted to help her. And, you know, he immediately went to poking holes. And she said, right, we're not at the poking hole stage yet. And so for me, when he said, you know, do you really need to be the one to release this? For me, that was, again, an indication that, you know, Spencer has not come to this place yet, that he is being fully supportive of her career. Because even in his help, right? And he, you know, he came around-ish eventually, right? They had that whole conversation. He was like, I'm not apologizing. But he came around-ish eventually. But yep, even still, it's like the getting back to this, even when I help you, even when I support you, I gotta poke holes in it. Like, I gotta...
Right.
You don't gotta be the one to release this. And so for me, I was just like, when is Spencer going to get to a point where it's just like, you know, I don't need any other confirmation. We're going all the way back to Wade, right? Like, I don't need any other confirmation. I'm just going to fully 1000% support you. And I think that him asking that question in that moment showed that he wasn't there yet. And so I think my question at the time was, when is Spencer going to get there? When is he going to get to, I 1000% support you, not just in my words and saying, I always got your back, but also in my actions. And then he comes back and the next episode and says, you know, she's giving him advice about whether or not to stay at GAU after everything goes down. Obviously she releases it under a pseudonym. He borrows her advice from the fallout and he tells her to find peace and pride by forgiving herself for the fallout of this article.
What?
And the thing is we went in on that. We went in on that. And I think now I'm just trying to understand, like, Spencer, was that your way? Like, is that the level that he could get to? Was that the only level that he could get to at the time? And was this the best way that he knew how to support? Because he really, I guess, just doesn't understand. But maybe him saying, like, you have to find peace and pride and you got to forgive yourself and et cetera, was his way of being supportive with her career.
Yeah.
I just feel like he could have a simple apology and I was wrong or I should have handled it better would have sufficed.
I agree.
Honestly.
I agree. But I think
but we never got that.
We never got it. And I think it just came because, you know, the article is pretty much done after 507. Obviously, there's some things where we'll talk about when she, you know, decides after post Billy's death to release her name and everything like that. But pretty much the article after this episode was the brunt of it was done. And I think that, you know, moving forward in this season, the way that Spencer showed his support post article release was essentially telling her that the article was not stupid, you know, when she was talking about, oh, you know, we broke up because of this thing and it was really stupid. And he's like, oh, it's not stupid. But that's really all that we got. Was him just being right. Like, no, you know, the article's great. And I was just like, but I mean, because it had already been released, so like, what are we gonna see?
Right.
What are we gonna see? Something like, you know, not retroactively. And it really bothered me because I felt like 506 really was the episode to show his growth because he had supported her and she already had that conversation with him about, you know, I'm still like, I'm not apologizing for what I've done and done and things like that. And still in 506, I really feel like that was the opportunity to show, hey, Spencer, in terms of Liv's journalism, has become 1000% a full supporter.
And he dropped the ball.
Yeah. And he dropped the ball. we'll get back to that when it comes to like later on in the season and her getting this award. But for now, they sort of switch back to not about Liv's career, not about her dreams. They're switching back to Spencer and Olivia together as a relationship, and it's Billy's birthday party. Mm-mm-mm. And this is the first time that they've been together and, you know, essentially they've been with other people in front of each other physically And they both are sort of learning how to deal with that. And we know that Liv's was more of a response to hearing that Spencer was bringing Alicia from Coop again.
Yeah, because he wasn't going to tell her. He was just going to bring this girl to her daddy's party as if she's not here.
Have her shook up at the party. Oh, look who I brought.
Right. But he does have this really nice speech, and they're trying to figure it out. And he says, oh, even the most important relationship in my life, I owe to Coach Baker. Obviously, he makes a joke about the tracksuit, but it's very clear who he's speaking about. And they agree at this party that they are going to figure out how to be friends. You know, Liv says there's no way that we can get back to what we were, but we can start something new, and we're going to figure out how to be friends. And so it's, what are we thinking at this time? What are y'all both thinking at, like, post eight, where they are, post journal, post article coming out? What's your thoughts on where Spencer and Olivia are
at this particular time at this birthday party?
Yeah, after the birthday party.
After the birthday party?
After the birthday party, and they agree, we're going to be friends. We're going to figure out how to be friends in this new way.
I think that they just actually tried. But they knew it wasn't going to work, like, deep down. But they just were like, okay, let me just try something.
That's nice. I don't think they tried. Well, let me take that back. I don't think he tried. And I'm going to tell you why. Because he has a whole girlfriend that he's sleeping with, bringing to the
birthday
party.
Not a girlfriend at the time. Remember, they were just having fun.
This was after you said, yeah, we were talking just after the birthday party.
Oh, right. When it became official.
So, yeah, let me chat. So he has a whole girl.
You're good. You're so fun. Go ahead.
Yeah. He has a whole girl he's sleeping with, brought to the birthday party. And he
Recent
was like,
girl, new girl.
New girl. Okay, how about that? New girl he's sleeping with, brought to the birthday party. And he's like, yeah, we can, like, do this friend thing. The minute he saw her with Noah in this candlelight, all bets were off. Because in his mind, he thought he can, like, do it, right? He was like, I don't even know, in his mind he thought he could do it, because he knew in his heart he couldn't. But the minute he saw her with Noah, he goes to a girl and was like, I want you to be my girlfriend. Because at the time he was like, I still have feelings for her. Alicia called him about being in love with Liv and all this other stuff. But he wasn't being truthful, because he literally wanted to be with Liv, and the idea of Liv even having, like, a candlelight dinner because the power went out rubbed him the wrong way.
Yeah, and let's talk about that, because that's 5:09. Had to pause it right there and stay tuned for the next part of our talk about Spelivia.